Hello everyone, I welcome you all to a very special session today. You should be very happy because you are going to invest the next 30 minutes of your time into something very beautiful. So today's session, we'll start with a simple question. Who are you? Though it looks simple, this has been one of the most difficult questions of all mankind. Today, we'll talk about a very beautiful aspect of yourself and therefore request you to listen to it with all your heart. So, if someone asks you, how's your life going? How many of you actually say that it's awesome, like I'm enjoying my life a lot? I doubt any of you will say that, right? For us, especially during teenage life, becomes a game of balance. You know, you see the girl here. Our situation is somewhat like that. On one side, we have our family, relatives, society, career, ambition, money, all those things that we have to achieve, you know, we have to have a good impression on. On the other hand, we have that recent crush, our friends, how do we look? Are we getting fat? And who could get the best abs? And you know, our social circle and our priorities are so different. And our priorities are at a contrast to each other. Unfortunately, all of us has got only 24 hours a day. And the choices that you make now are going to have a huge impact on you throughout your life. So now let's talk a bit about a general issue that all of us face. This is how we usually study. No matter how hard we are trying to understand the stuff in front of us, mind is playing some creepy background music. And eventually this is how we end up studying. The phone beeps and we have to see that latest Instagram story. What it leads to is this. A distracted mind even during exams. And what it further leads to is a lot of peer pressure. It's not only about scoring good marks, it's about having that, you know, having the concept in your mind. And with such a distracted mind, this is something how we end up. Enough talking about the problems that we have to face. After all, it comes from inside and we can't really help it. Let's talk about this balloon here. What do you think makes it rise high in the air? Is it the inside air or the outside air? Yes, I know. All of you know the answer. That is inside air. Now, guess the person on the screen. This is a very simple one. Our beloved Mahatma Gandhi. What he did was impossible without tremendous inner strength. And he says that there is a force in the universe which, if we permit it, will flow through us and produce miraculous results. We are going to tell you about the same power which our Mahatma is talking about. Any guesses on who is he? He is the great painter and inventor Leonardo da Vinci, whose painting is still considered as the best artwork in all of history. So, he tells us, where the spirit does not work with the hand, there is no art. Is this the secret behind his amazing work? How can our spirit work with hands? We'll unfold that secret today. Now, who is this person? Maybe all of us have seen an old age picture of him, the great Albert Einstein. He says, everyone who is seriously involved in the pursuit of science becomes convinced that a spirit is manifest in the laws of the universe, a spirit vastly superior to that of man, and one in the face of which we, with our modest powers, must feel humble. To sum it up, he summarizes that there's a spirit that works through us. A spirit which is vastly superior to man. a spirit that Vinci has also talked about. A person of science and arts talk about the same thing. Let's discover this mystery today. Who is he? I'm sure we all must have read his poems in our English textbooks. The great Rabindranath Tagore. He says, "Only in silence I find myself." It's important to know that our biggest resources are in our hearts. And silence means meditation. So let's discover ourselves today through meditation. So we have just seen that great leaders from different backgrounds, be it scientific, political, literature, all have been pointing towards a very special power. The special power which has helped them through all their ventures. This special power is there in everyone. You, me, and everyone. This power is known as Mother Kundalini, and it sits in our sacrum bone at the bottom of our spine. When we meditate, this power rises through our central channel and nourishes us. It gives us strength from inside. Let's look more about how she really helps us. We'll be starting with the experience session very shortly. Right now, there's nobody around you to force you to listen to us. If you really want a big change in your life, then this is the moment. Just ask for it with all your heart, and I'm sure your Mother Kundalini will make you feel her love. I did it and I felt it, and that is why I tell you to do it. Before we actually get started, let's prepare ourselves a bit. Let us all sit comfortably either on floor or on a chair, but make sure to make contact with your bare feet with the Mother Earth, because she helps you in this experience. We have to just relax and sit with our palms facing upwards and be in a very comfortable position. Before getting started, I'll walk you through the steps that we are going to do. You need not learn them because we'll do them again along with Sri Mataji, who has given all of this knowledge to us. The steps are very simple. you just have to use your right hand to place it at locations of various chakras on the left part of your body. So the first step is that we'll take our right hand and we'll place it on our heart. Here we'll ask Mother, am I the pure spirit? Then we'll place our right hand on the upper portion of the abdomen and we'll say, Mother, am I my own guru? Then we'll take this hand to the lower portion of our abdomen and we'll say, Mother, please give me pure knowledge. Then we'll take our hand back to the upper portion of our abdomen and we'll say, Mother, I am my own guru. Now we bring back our hand back to our heart and as an answer to the question that we had asked earlier, we'll say, Mother, I am the pure spirit. Afterwards, we'll take our right hand between our neck and shoulder on the left hand side and we'll twist our head a bit towards the right hand side. You need not worry much about it. It's really simple and it's no problem even if you do it a bit wrong. Now comes a very important step. Place your right hand on your forehead and here say, Mother, I forgive everyone, including myself. Say it with all your heart. Then place this hand on the back side of your head and here say, Mother, please forgive me for all the mistakes that I have made. Just ask for forgiveness. After that, place your right hand on the top portion of your head, press it a bit, little bit. Stretch your palm, place the center portion on your head and press it with a little force and say, Mother, please give me my self-realization.
Forget your past. To forgive yourself, you should be pleasantly placed towards yourself. Pleasantly placed towards yourself. And second one is that you have to forgive everyone. As I told you yesterday, whether you forgive or don't forgive, you don't do anything. Actually, if you don't forgive, then you play into wrong hands. So just neglect it completely. Don't worry about it. And in general, you should say, I forgive everyone. Just say, in general, I forgive everyone. That's all. Not to count how many people you have to forgive, not to know about everyone, what they have said to you, but just forgive in general. That's all. So the first one is to forget your past. That means not to feel guilty at all. You are not to feel guilty. After all, you are a human being, and human beings can only commit mistakes. You are not gods. So what does it matter? There's nothing to bother you on that point, should not. So please forgive yourself and forgive others. That's very important. These are the two simple conditions. But mentally, you should accept them. Now, we have to put both our feet little away from each other because you know there are two powers within us, left and right. And we use our left hand symbolically to suggest that we want our self-realization and this is the power of desire, not of pure desire but desire. And we use our right hand, which is the power of action, to nourish our centers. On the left hand side, we'll be nourishing our left hand centers only. Now, please put your left hand towards me and right hand on your heart. Now, close your eyes. Please don't open them till I tell you. Here you have to ask me a question, a very important question. You can call me Mother or you can call me Sri Mataji, whatever you like. Very important question. Ask a question three times in your heart, not loudly, please. Mother, am I the Spirit? Mother, am I the Spirit? Ask this question three times. If you are the Spirit, you are your own guide. You are your own master. So now please bring down your hand, right hand, in the upper portion of your abdomen on the left hand side, press it hard. And here ask another question three times. Mother, am I my own master? Ask this question three times. Mother, am I my own master? Now, as I told you, I respect your freedom and you have a free will. And I cannot force pure knowledge on you. It cannot be. You have to ask for it. So now take your right hand in the lower portion of your abdomen on the left hand side and ask me, Mother, please give me pure knowledge. Six times, because this center has got six petals. Mother, please give me pure knowledge. As soon as you ask this question, the Kundalini starts moving upward. So now we have to nourish the upper centers to make its movement, her movement, faster. So please raise your right hand in the upper portion of your abdomen on the left hand side, press it hard, and here you say with full confidence. With full confidence you say, Mother, I am my own master. Please say it 10 times. Mother, I am my own master. These things remove your conditionings from wrong teachings. Now you raise your hand to the most important question. That is, you are not your body, you are not your intelligence, you are not your emotions, you are not your conditionings, your ego, your thoughts, but you are pure spirit. So raise your right hand on to your heart and say with full confidence 12 times. Full confidence, please. Mother, I am the Spirit. Just say that. Mother, I am the Spirit. Please say 12 times. Now, raise your right hand to another very important area within us, where by feeling guilty all the time, we have harmed a very important center. I have to tell you that the divine power is the ocean of knowledge and love. It is the ocean of bliss and joy. But above all, it is the ocean of forgiveness. And whatever mistakes or wrongs you have done are dissolved by the power of forgiveness. So raise your right hand into the corner of your neck and your shoulder and turn your head to your right. Here you have to say with full confidence 16 times, Mother, I am not guilty at all. Again you say, Mother, I am not guilty at all. 16 times. I have already told you, whether you forgive others or not, you are not doing anything, it is a myth. But if you don't forgive others, then you fall into the wrong hands and torture yourself for nothing. So now, please raise your right hand onto your forehead across, press it hard on both the sides and put down your head as far as possible, resting on your hand, and press it on both the sides. This is the center where you have to forgive. Forgive others, forgive others. Just say, Mother, I forgive everyone without thinking about them or thinking about what they have done to you. Just say, in general, Mother, I forgive everyone now. How many times is not the point from your heart? You must say it properly. Yesterday so many didn't say and I had to work very hard on them. So please say it. Please say it from your heart. Once for all, Mother, I forgive everyone. Now take back your hand on the back side of your head, on the optic lobe, and now raise it higher and let it rest on your hand. Here you have to say, for your own satisfaction, not feeling guilty, not counting your mistakes, O Divine Power, if I have done any mistakes, please forgive me. Say it from your heart. Now, stretch your palm, keeping your left hand towards me. This is the most important center, both the feet apart from each other. Keep yourself straight and put your right hand, the center of your palm, On top of the fontanelle bone area, the soft bone which you had in your childhood, and press it. Now bend your head as much as you can. Press back your fingers, press back your thumb. So there's a pressure on your scalp, nicely pressurized. Now move it. Move it slowly 7 times. Here again, I cannot disrespect your freedom and free will. You have to ask for your self-realization. It cannot be forced on you. So 7 times, please say, 7 times, Mother, please give me my self-realization. Please say it 7 times. Now, please take down your both the hands and open your eyes slowly, very slowly. Now watch me without thinking. You can do it. Now, put up your right hand like this and bend your head and see for yourself if there's a cool breeze coming out of your head. Bend your head. It is above your head, not on. So little away from the head. You try to feel if there's a cool breeze coming out of your head. You can take your hand little further. Some people have it quite away from the head. So see for yourself there's a cool breeze coming in. Now put the left hand towards me. And put down your head. Now see for yourself again with the right hand. If there's a cool breeze coming out of your head. Some people will get heat coming out, doesn't matter. It will later on be followed by a cool breeze also.
We'll be in the state of meditation for a little more while. And we'll see and feel what we are feeling on our hands, inside us, and on the top of our head. Calm, relaxed inside, or maybe some vibrations. This experience is unique for all of us. The first time I felt it, I felt really calm inside and some vibrations on the top of my head. You may feel something else. So let us know about that in the chat window. So, as we all know, in order to learn anything, we need to practice it. Same goes for meditation. The only thing is, you don't have to put in a lot of effort. Rather, you have to put no effort at all. All you have to do is that when you wake up in the morning, just get up and before doing anything else, you know, before busying your mind again, just sit down on Mother Earth for a little while and pray. Pray to Mother Earth. Keep both your hands on Mother Earth and just pray to her, Mother, please take away all my negativities, all that makes me feel bad, into yourself and make me a pure child. Then, after a minute or two, just put both your hands on your lap, open and just pray, Mother Kundalini, please bless me to be a beautiful child. Whatever you want, you can pray to Mother Kundalini and she'll be there for you. You can do this before studying and it will help you to improve your concentration. It's a beautiful experience, and as you do it more and more, it goes stronger. Another great philosopher has said that what lies behind us and what lies ahead of us are tiny matters compared to what lives within us. So, your beauty lies within yourself and neither in your past or your future. We'll talk about this more in the next session. So, we hope to see you again. Until then, keep meditating, keep experiencing, and keep growing from inside. Thank you.